So this is my contraband, and it's an examination of the interracial relationship presented in the story. We have Louisa May Alcott, who was born in 1832. She was born to Bronson and Abigail Alcott. She was also one of four daughters. Her father was an incredibly smart man and also a transcendentalist. He was friends with Henry Thoreau, Nathaniel Hawthorne, Ralph Waldo Emerson, Theodore Parker, and Margaret Fuller. Her father was not very dependable as far as bringing in money, and so she would work. She would sew and teach, write, and edit to help bring in money. She was also a nurse at the Union Hospital during the Civil War, and that is where she contracted the typhoid fever, which we see her presenting in My Contraband. So the basic plot is there's an officer brought to the Union Hospital, and she is given, or he is given into her care. There's also a contraband with her, and a contraband is a freed slave. And so his name is Bob, and they have a strange relationship. She notices certain things about him, that he's a light-skinned and he has a haughty disposition towards other slaves, and she one night is lulled into sleep. He closes the door, and he makes the room warm, which makes her fall asleep. And she notices that he, when she wakes up, she notices that he's trying to kill the officer, and it's revealed that the officer is his brother, his half brother, and there has been some tension between the two. And so she convinces him not to kill the brother, and they don't see each other for a while, and she sees him later, and he is dying of battle wounds, and she says that his or they she is told that his name is Robert Dane, and so she has feelings that his name has been changed and he has taken her name. And so in one of the last scenes, it's a very intense and powerful scene because they share an intense look, and then he dies. And so the relationships between him and her, and him and the other slaves, and him and the captain are what we're going to examine. So the movies that we're going to use to examine this are going to be 12 Years a Slave, which is an incredible movie, and it's an adaptation of the 1853 memoirs from Solomon Northup, who is this gentleman here. This is a drawing of him, and this is the actor that plays him in the movie. In Django, or in Django Unchained, you have Jamie Foxx playing Django in this movie, and he has a wife who is stolen from him, and he has to go through tons of obstacles to try to get her back. And it's a very intense movie, and it does have some nudity and some violent fight scenes, strong slave narrative, and strong language. So if you ever want to go and watch the movie, just be prepared for what you're going to see. In The Free State of Jones, we have Matthew McConaughey here, who is playing Newton Knight, and he was a Confederate Army deserter who went down south. Somewhere around Mississippi, I think, and he rallied the freed slaves and the smaller farmers, and they led a militia against the Confederate government that was in their area. And this movie provides a perspective of faith that I think is best paralleled with this movie. So Faith Dane, she was an army nurse, much like Louisa May Alcott was. And she was given the task of watching over the rebel officer, and she is intrigued with this mulatto contraband. And I noticed that with the gash that is put upon Robert's face, it humanizes him, because the description that Alcott uses would have made him less appealing to white readers. And so, yeah, her relationship with him is a special one. It's an unusual one, and it allows us to see her compassion for him and what he's been through and the situations that have gone on. And in this scene, we have Mrs. Solomon, or Mrs. Epps, and her interaction with Solomon. This is a negative reaction, and so we'll see this.
This is a list of goods and sundries. You will take it to be filled and return immediately. Take your tag. Tell Bartholomew to add it to our debt.
Yes, miss.
Where are you from, Platt?
I told you.
Tell me again.
Washington.
Who were your master?
Master name of Freeman.
Was he a learned man?
I suppose so.
He learned you to read?
A word, here or there. But I've no understanding of the written text.
Don't trouble yourself with it. Same as the rest, master bought you here to work, that's all. Any more, I'll earn you 100 lashes.
Okay, so that scene right there would have been what Faith Dane would not have done. And I wanted to include that to show the compassion that she does have. The next clip is a very positive one, and it shows the compassion of Newt Knight, and I would liken that to the compassion of Faith Dane. And so this is from Free State of Jones.
Mr. Moses, what are you? Free man, Captain. Why's that? Because you cannot own a child of God. No, you cannot, can you?
Unfortunately, this is the best thing that I could find, and it does go green, so.
You can own a horse, you can own a mule, or a cow, or an ox. You cannot own a child of God.
So that scene right there, I think, is the best representation of the relationship between Faith, Nurse Faith, and Robert. In this scene, you have Newt Knight speaking to Moses, and in this era, you know, it was hard for the slaves to be seen as people, and so Newt Knight, he recognizes Moses as a human being, as a child of God, and I thought that relationship was best paralleled with the relationship of Faith and Robert. And so you have Robert Dane, who is a free slave, and he does have a high and mighty disposition towards other slaves, which the scene that I found to best represent this is from Django Unchained, and it is not the best representation of Robert's character, I would say, but it's the best representation of a slave who has certain privileges compared to a slave or compared to another black person. And so Robert Dane is set on revenge, and he, as I've mentioned before, he does have the scar across his face, which I think does humanize him. And so in this next clip, you'll see this character right here, Stephen. He would be the high and mighty slave reacting to Django, and this also presents the relationship between these two characters. This is Calvin, and he is the slave owner of this man, but the relationship between them is a very unusual one, and so we'll see that in the next scene.
Hello, Stephen, my boy.
Yeah. Hello, my ass.
Who this nigga up on that name?
Oh, Stephen, you have nails for breakfast. What's the matter? Why are you so ornery? You miss me, huh?
Oh, yes, sir. I miss you like a whole Miss Slop, like a baby. Miss Mammy Titty. I miss you like I misses a rock in my shoe. Now, I ask you, who this nigga on that name?
It's Snowball. Wanna know my name or the name of my horse? You ask me.
That's who the hell you calling Snowball, hoss boy? I'll snatch your black ass off that nag down in the mud.
Whoa,
so fast, make your
head. Steven. Let's keep it funny. Django here is a freeman.
Okay, so you have that interaction, which is an interesting one, especially the relationship between Calvin and Steven. you know, Calvin is accepting the way that Stephen is talking to him, and that is a relationship that would not have been very usual. Now, the relationship between Django and Stephen is one filled with tension. Stephen is wondering who this man is on this horse, as slaves could not own their own horses or ride horses. They would have to walk or be dragged behind the horses. And so this is a interesting relationship dynamic that I thought was best representing how Robert felt about the other slaves and how he would call them the N-word and how he would not want to be with them because he thought that he was better. And so with Stephen, you have a bit of that in his disposition. And so let's see. And so you have the captain. His relationship is very easily found in slave movies. He's the man who is in charge of all the slaves and all that stuff. And so he's the brutal man. He's the half-brother of Robert. He abused Robert's wife, which is part of the reason why Robert has such a strong disposition against the captain. And so in this scene we have from 12 Years a Slave, this is Solomon and Epps, and this is a scene between a slave owner and a slave over a woman. And I thought that was kind of a good comparison for relationships.
Brought her back just as instructed. What'd you just now tell her? What'd you say to Bates? No words were spoken, none of consequence. You're a liar. You're a damn liar. I saw you talking with her. Tell me. Can I speak of what did not occur?
Oh, Christ, Black, bro! Christ!
You come here.
Master Adam.
I said come here!
I brought her back just like you.
Come here, Master!
Okay, so that situation right there is, as you can see, very tense, and the slave owner has a strong infatuation with Patsy, and Solomon, while he is married, he is just trying to protect Patsy as much as a slave can against a slave owner. And so that relationship right there is symbolic to me of Robert and the rebel officer and Robert's wife. And so that relationship is the cause of Robert's revenge seeking and pain, and I think that Faith Dane recognizes that in him. And so you have Lucy, she's the wife of Robert, and she has killed herself, as Robert finds out in the story, after the mistreatment by the captain. And like I said, it's the cause of Robert's intense hatred of the rebel officer. And Alcott does well of leading up to this drastic realization of what has happened to his wife. And so in this next scene, we have Patsy right here speaking to Mr. Epps, and then Solomon standing in the back examining.
I went to Master Shaw's plantation.
You admit it.
Yes, freely. And you know why? I got this from Mrs. Shaw. Mrs. Epps won't even grab me no soap to clean with. I stink so much to make myself gag. £500 of cotton, day in, day out. More than any man here.
So that situation right there is what would leave Lucy to have killed herself. Patsy was very abused, she was very mistreated, and so she couldn't take anymore, and so she did kill herself. Now, the relationships portrayed in My Contraband can be seen in many different forms in movies concerning slavery. Alcott was able to portray Miss Dane as a compassionate woman who cared for Black people, just like Newt Knight, and she didn't make the situation crude or unrelatable. And the clips are provided to help give a mental picture of the story. Interracial relationships were not acceptable, but there were a brave few who defied the standard of that time and entered into them anyways. In 12 Years a Slave, there is a man who is married to a Black woman. Alcott does a great job of presenting those relationships in a classy manner, and these clips are just examples to provide a mental picture to help better understand the situations that slaves and their owners and free people were put into.